Hi everyone, my name is Eve. I traveled all over Menorca as well as many of the other holiday destinations in Spain. And in this video, I want to give you my complete guide to everything you need to know to have the best holiday possible in Menorca. This includes everything you need to know, things to do, things definitely not to do, things to see on the island, the hotels you should be staying at, where to go, where not to go, also when you should travel to Menorca, also how to get around on the island, and many, many more tips and tricks to make your holiday on Menorca the best one possible. In the first part of this guide, I want to focus on the best hotels. I visited over 80 of the best hotels on Menorca and picked out in this video 10 of the best ones. But you can always find the full list of the hotels I would advise on my website at checkedholidays.com. Also, I want to give you an overview of all the different holiday destinations so you can pick the right one for you as well.
The first holiday destination in Menorca I wanted to talk about is Sonbu. Sonbu is very close to the airport, so meaning it's very easy to get to. Do know that Sonbu is a little bit of a strange place. It's different than most of the other resorts, as most of the development here is residential real estate. There is, however, a small part of the town of the resort that has some really nice hotels, some really nice bars. So do check on the map if you are booking any of the hotels that is located in the right location, close to this center part of town where you have all the restaurants nearby. Also the beach nearby, and it's a really good location to be in. The next holiday destination I wanted to talk about is Santo Tomas. It's just a few kilometers away from Sonbu, but it's a very different place. This is a much more touristy destination, I would say, and it also has some of the more modern and upscale hotels on Menorca. So if you're looking for a really holiday, a touristy holiday, then this could be a great place for you, especially for families who are looking for new and modern and a very well-maintained place to go on holiday in Menorca. This could be the right choice for you. One of the hotels I can definitely advise here is the Hotel 55 Santo Tomas. This is a very new and modern feeling hotel. It got great views because it's located a little bit up on the hill, so you have great views over the rest of Santo Tomas. And also because of this higher location and the south orientation of the hotel, you got pretty much sun all day round around the pool. So if you like to stay at the pool, want to sunbathe, a great hotel for you. Next up in Menorca is Cala Galdana. Cala Galdana, the first thing you will notice here when you arrive is the amazingly beautiful beach. The beach here is really nice. In my opinion, one of the best beaches within the resorts in Menorca. So if you like a beach holiday, I can definitely advise this as a location. But also, if you like it a bit more active, from here you can hike to two other beaches nearby. You can go mountain biking here, kayaking, and loads of water sports. So also, if you like an active holiday, something I can definitely advise. There's a small little town here with some playgrounds for the kids and a few restaurants, but not too much of everything, keeping it nice and compact feeling. One of the hotels I can definitely advise you here is the Atrium Odax. It's a great hotel for those who like to be sporty or like to relax. If you like to relax, then they have a lot of facilities in the hotel to do so, as well as a great pool up on the roof that has a really relaxing setting and great views over Cala Galdana. If you like to be a little bit more active, then they also organize from the hotel lots of water sports and other types of sports, and they also have a big gym in the hotel for those who this is important for. Also, do know that this hotel is aimed at adults only. Next up is Calan Bosch. This is one of the bigger, if not the biggest, holiday destination on Menorca. There's lots of choice here from everything. There's two different beaches here, very different beaches from each other, one more touristy and one more rough and untouched, I would say. There's also loads of restaurants here. There's even a Burger King here at the time I'm making this video. So lots of different things to choose from. Also a very active nightlife in the evening. There's loads of little performances in the harbor area. There's also lots of restaurants, different variety of restaurants to choose from. So no matter what you like, if you like a really touristy holiday with lots of choice and lots of offer, or if you're staying 2 weeks on Menorca and you definitely don't want to run out of things to see and do, then this could be the ideal destination for you on Menorca. Even though Calan Bosch has one of the more active nightlifes on Menorca, do know that this place is still very family friendly, so don't expect to go clubbing here or have any discotheques or something. It's not this kind of place, but then Menorca in general doesn't have these kind of places. It's very family friendly nightlife. Calanbosch, as I mentioned, is very big, so that means also that there's many different hotels here, so also many great hotels. One I can definitely advise is the Port Blue La Quinta. This is a great, compact, but spacious feeling hotel. It's also great for those who are looking for a luxury holiday. And if you like to be close to the pool, then opt for a ground floor room, because they have pretty much direct access to the great pool that is centrally located in the hotel. Another hotel I can definitely advise in the Calanbosch is the Menorca Casas del Lago. This is a great centrally located hotel, very close to the harbor, overlooking the harbor where most of the nightlife is, as well as many restaurants and bars. The hotel itself has this kind of funky Ibiza style vibe to it. That's the only way I can describe it. And also this hotel is aimed at adults only holidays. Another hotel I can definitely advise is the Carema Beach Hotel. This is a great hotel in a great location. It's not only close to the harbor and the restaurants and the nightlife in this area, but far enough away not to be disturbed by it. It's also right next to a beautiful beach, so ideal for those who are looking to spend a lot of time on the beach. The whole hotel has this kind of fresh and airy, breezy vibe, so really nice for a beach or pool holiday. Another hotel I can definitely advise here is the Zafiro Menorca. It's also close to the town center and where most of the nightlife is, but as I said, far enough away from it not to be disturbed by it. Also know that there is lots of activities in the hotel for the entire family, so for all different age groups. Also do know that there's lots of different pools, also for all kinds of ages. There's an adults only pool, there's a kids pool, there's like a general activity pool. So very nice, especially good for families with children. The Calablanca in Menorca I would most advise for people who like a relaxing holiday, with especially smaller children who like to come and relax in Menorca, mostly in the hotel or on the beach. If that's the type of holiday you're looking for, then Calablanca might be the ideal destination for you on Menorca. The Cala Sant'Andrea is just a little bit further away and actually also within walking distance from the Cala Blanca. Cala Sant'Andrea is a nice little beach resort. There's only two or three hotels here, really not so much, but it's mostly about the beach and the nice relaxing bay that they have here. So if you like to relax, spend time on the beach, this could be a great holiday destination for you in Menorca. Here you will also find one of my favorite beach holiday hotels on the island. This is the Playa Sant'Andrea Unique Hotel. It's right next to this great beach. It's also a quiet and relaxed location, so really ideal if you want to relax on the beach. Also know that the hotel itself is quite small and compact, which makes it really easy to go from and to the hotel from and to the beach. So really easy if you just want to run in and out or get changed or anything like this. Very good hotel. Also located close to this beach, but a very different hotel, is the Prince Hotel La Cayeta. It's a much, much bigger hotel with very many different gardens and pools to enjoy. Also within the hotel, there's many different restaurants you can choose from, so loads of different dining options. But overall, this hotel also have a very peaceful and relaxing location. Ciutadella used to be the capital of Menorca, but now has been replaced with Mahon on the other side of the island. So this really ain't a touristy destination. There is also not really a beach here. There is one, but it's really not really the nicest one. Ciutadella I would most advise for people who like a little bit of a cultural holiday or a city holiday or an adults only holiday, and most likely also are renting a car to explore more of the island. This is really a good place to be then, as you can really drive easily from Ciutadella all over the island, because most of the roads go through Ciutadella. Calablanes is one of the biggest holiday destinations on Menorca. This is also where most of the tourism takes place on the island. There's loads of bars and restaurants in the town center. There's four different beaches to choose from, very different beaches to each other. So if you like to change location and go to other beaches from one day to the next, this could also be a great place. In the evening, also in the town square, there's loads of family-friendly nightlife. So lots of restaurants, but also small performances and things to see and do. Also, there's a water park here, so very family-friendly place all round to go to Calanblanes in Menorca. Next up is the Cala Morei in Menorca. This is one of the most untouched holiday destinations on the island. There's not really so much development here. There's just a nice beach and lots of villas and stuff for rent. So if you like that kind of holiday, this could be a good place for you on Menorca. Next up is Fornés in the north of Menorca. The north in general is one of the less developed and more untouched destinations in a good way. So it's still very authentic here and very much about nature. There's only a few apartment complexes and hotels here and some really nice beaches. From the town next door of the harbor of Fornés, you have great possibilities to go and explore the sea and different beaches nearby by boat and also do loads of different water sports. Then we come to Son Park, another one of these destinations in the north of Menorca. There's a nice beach here. It's really quite a relaxing holiday destination. And it's also about the golf course here. There's a big golf course. So if you like to play golf and relax, then this is a definite place I can advise on Menorca. Another one of these places in the north of Menorca, but a bit bigger and a bit more developed, I would say, is Arenai de Gastei, a very nice beach here. There's loads of different restaurants and bars in the small town. There's also a small water park and fun things to do for the kids nearby. The one thing I do want to say is that this area is quite hilly. So if you are traveling with people with a disability or with small children in pushchairs, this might not be the best destination for you on Menorca. Next up is Mahon. Mahon is the cultural heart of Menorca. So this is really not a beach holiday destination, but a lot of tourists do come here for the culture and things to see and do and experience, as well as the great food and the markets. If you are renting a car, this however could also be a great place for you to stay on the island, as from Mahon you can easily drive pretty much everywhere on the island and explore many different towns, but also different beaches nearby, as well as many different things to see and do. Also here you will find one of my favorite hotels. This is the Barceló Hamilton Menorca. It's a boutique style city hotel. It's very close to Mahon. You can walk there, but it is easier to have a car with you. If you are renting a car, then it's also a great place to explore the rest of the island from, as you're really close to the highway, to get on and off the highway and explore the rest of the island. And also do know that this hotel is only for adults only. A small drive away from Mahon and also very close to the airport is Salgar. This is a very nice place. It's not very big. There's just a few hotels and apartment complexes here. However, there ain't really a beach, but there is a nice swimming platform next to the beach club from where you can swim in the sea. So not really a beach, but still a very nice place to enjoy the sea without getting all the sand everywhere. So if you like this kind of holiday, this could be a great destination for you. A little bit further away is the Punta Prima, also very close to the airport, so very easy to get to, a short drive from the airport. Punta Prima is mostly for the all-inclusive holidays that they offer in this area. Big all-inclusive hotels where you can find pretty much everything you want in the hotel. However, outside of the hotels, there's also a nice small beach. And near the beach, there's also a few little restaurants to choose from. Not too many, but what they do have here is quite a bit of variety and different things to choose from. Also, there's a nice little water park nearby if you would like to go to the water park. Also here you will find one of my favorite hotels, the Inshotel Punta Prima. This is a great hotel, a very big hotel, very large hotel, so with a lot of choice of pretty much everything when it comes to food, when it comes to activities, when it comes to playgrounds and pools. You have lots of choice here. Also do know that this is very close to the nice beach that they have here, and they have an amazing spa as well in the hotel. Next up, and also close to the airport, is Binibeca. It's a pretty special place. You either like it or you don't. If you're looking for new and modern and big hotels, then this isn't the right place for you. It offers mostly houses and villas and residential places to rent in this area. Calanporter is one of the smallest destinations you can go on holiday to in Menorca. If you want to get away from it all experience mixed in with some of the pure Spanish vibes, this might be a great choice for you. Do know that this area is quite hilly, so if you have people with you with pushchairs or people with a disability, this is not really a great place for you. However, the beach here has some nice white sands and really clear blue water. In the evening, one of the great places to enjoy here is the Coves d'Encheroi, where you can really relax, sit back and look over the sea.
In the next part of this guide, I want to focus a little bit on what there is to see and do on the island. There's lots of excursions, day trips and stuff to go on. Which one are worth doing, which one are not worth doing, and which one you should definitely not do, I want to cover in this next part of this video.
So the Montaña del Toro is definitely one of these places I would advise you to go and have a look. From here you have an overview of the entire island, so it's a really good way to get an understanding of where everything is. So maybe this is best to do on your first day when you just arrive, especially if you have a rental car. Just drive up here, it doesn't take much time, but you really get an understanding of where all the resorts are, where all the attractions are, and a little bit where you are yourself on the island as well. So definitely it's a free place. There's also a chapel up here. You can go and have a look. There's like a little bar. There's also other things to do, but just to get an overview of the island, this is a great place to visit. One of the most unique experiences on the island, I think, has to be the Cova Don Charroi. These caves overlooking the sea from the cliff tops can be enjoyed in the daytime with a chill drink, but you can also go there in the nighttime, where it's more like a nightclub vibe, and this might actually be the best night out on the island. If you're looking to go clubbing and partying, this is a great destination in the night. So Citadella and Mahon, should you visit these places in Menorca? Well, it depends a little bit on what you want, but if you really want to get a feel for the island and experience some of the local culture, then yes. Citadella used to be the capital, but Mahon is the capital of Menorca at this moment. So both have some ancient historic buildings, there's markets and great places to eat. My advice would just be to go to the one that's closest to you, or if you're passing any of these cities on your way, just stop there. But don't necessarily, if you're staying on one side of the island, drive all the way to the other side of the island just to see Mahon. In my opinion, it's not worth it. If you're really into culture, it might be worth it, but just go to the one that's closest to you. I think that will be the best fit for most people. So one thing I always see popping up in the comments of these kind of videos is always about tapas. Where do you really eat great tapas? Well, most of the restaurants, if you look in the street, they will claim that they have the best and most traditional tapas, but it's not really the case. One place I do know on Menorca is to go to Mahon. Here in the local fish market, the Mercat des Peiks in Mahon, there you really have a great offer of local tapas. So if you really want to try some traditional and authentic tapas in Mahon, in the local fish market, there you can have the best fish and the best tapas, real authentic Spanish tapas, if you want to try them. So one of the places I do want to advise you, even though I haven't been there myself, is the Son Martoje, hard to pronounce, the Son Martorellet. Reyet, that has to be because it's Spanish. Son Marto Reyet, equestrian show, so horse show. I haven't been there myself, just as a quick disclaimer, but I heard so many people say good things about it, especially when they went to visit with like younger children or up to like 12, 14 years old. They have a really good time here. So for this reason, I still want to include it in this video that you should go and have a look there if you have younger children, especially. There's lots of water sports to do in Menorca. You see quite a few people practicing the paddling, the standing up on a surfboard and going around like this. But one of the more popular things even here too is to rent a kayak. It's quite easy actually, even if you've never done it before, it's quite easy to get around. You get the hang of it pretty fast. You can go on organized excursions or you can go by yourself, and it's really a great way since there's not so many coastal roads in Menorca if you want to explore a little bit of the coastline. But as I mentioned, if you feel a little bit uncomfortable going by yourself, you can always go on an organized tour and the guides will really take you to the places that are really nice. So go on one of the tours, but definitely there's a lot of different tour options. Read the reviews before online to make sure that you're going on a good tour where you will go and see nice places. So this is a little bit of a weird tip, I kind of know, but I just picked this drink up off the shelf because it looked interesting by accident, but kept buying it for the rest of my stay here. I think this is something typical Spanish or from Menorca, but it was so good, I just kind of like had to include it in this video. I would definitely advise you to try it as well when you're on Menorca. Your perfect summer beach drink for your holiday in Menorca. This is the Fonter Lime and Lemon, and no, this is not sponsored. No one is paying me to say this or include this in here. It's really good drink, really refreshing, really ideal for on the beach, so give it a try. Menorca has also some amazing beaches. I cannot cover them all in this video. I have a different video where I cover them all. It's on your screen right now. So if you want to learn more about the beaches, I would advise you to go and have a look at that video after this one. So I talked about some amazing things that Menorca has to offer, but I also want to talk about this other thing that is a little bit more negative, but I think it's important to talk just about the good, but also about the bad. And this is one thing that I've been noticing in many other places in Spain. Also here in Menorca, this isn't a typical Menorca thing, but it is something that happens in Menorca, is that there's kind of like dodgy rip-off car rental companies. Many of them do very good service, but you do need to know which one you have to pick. But when I was picking up my car, I also saw at the other windows of other companies that people were in discussions, that they had to pay extra fees and things like this. If you are renting a car, great. It's awesome to explore Menorca, but do it in the right way. You can find the company I used and all the trips and ticks I use when traveling around Spain on my website at checkedholidays.com/car to make sure you have a nice, smooth start of your holiday.
In the next part of this video, I'm going to talk a little bit more about when is the right time for you to visit Menorca. A lot of people think it's August and July, but this is not the right choice for most people. Also, there are some months you definitely want to avoid, and there are some great months on the island that are specifically, for example, hiking or sunbathing, or if you want to have a summer holiday or beach holiday. Which ones are the best, I want to cover in this next part of this video guide.
January, February, March, April, November, and December are normally not good months to come to Menorca, at least not for most people, as most people like to come to Menorca for the summer holidays, and this time of year it's not hot and quite rainy. If you are coming for maybe a more cultural holiday to visit the capital of Mahon, or if you're coming on a hiking holiday like a lot of people come to do around this time, then I would aim not at November and December because these are the most rainy. January and February it gets better, but the best weather, less rainy and also more hot, you will find in March and April. If you're traveling to Menorca on a budget or want to come here for the water sports, like a lot of people come here on holiday for, then the best months are May, September and October. These have quite nice temperatures already, with the high being somewhere on average 24 degrees and the low 14 degrees Celsius, but there's also going to be days that is going to be much hotter, of course, as well. The rainy days you have still quite a few of, on average 9, but most of these are in October. May, I would say there is much less rain and also less rainy days, so May is much more drier than September and definitely than October. But sea temperature is on average 21 degrees Celsius. In May, the sea is much colder than, by example, in September, when the sea temperature is normally a little bit higher. So if you're traveling on a budget, then I would say travel in the first half of May to get the best deals and the cheapest deals. In September, normally you have the best weather, and if you want another budget holiday after the summer months, then I would look at October, as you get really good deals, especially towards the ending, and you may or may not be lucky with the weather and the rain and the sun. Do also know that at the beginning of May, there is not many people on Menorca, as well as at the ending of October. This means that it's nice and relaxing and quiet, but it also means that some restaurants may not be open yet or are starting to close down, as counts the same for the hotels and the bars and attractions. If you are coming in May, September and October, do also remember that you need to bring a jacket or something warm, because sometimes it can get quite windy in the evening, meaning that it's quite cold and you might need a jacket, especially sometimes in the evenings. If you're looking for the hottest and driest summer holiday weather, then I would definitely aim for either June, July or August. These have really good temperatures and there's almost no rain. The average high temperature will be around 28 degrees for the high and 20 degrees for the low. But these are averages, so there's also going to be plenty of days it's going to be much hotter than that. There's almost no rain, especially not in July and August. Think 1 to maximum 2 days of rain a month, and also the sea temperature is really nice and comfortable with a pleasant 24 degrees. If you can travel in June, especially towards the ending of June, I would definitely try to do this, as it's also much cheaper normally than July and August, and the weather is about the same. And also in July and August, it gets much more busy than June on Menorca.
In the next part of this video, I want to give you a clear guide to what is the best way for you to get from the Menorca airport to your hotel in a cheap, fast and efficient way.
The first way to get from the Menorca airport to your holiday destination or hotel in Menorca is just to take the public bus or the public transportation. Do know that this is very easy because you can just buy the ticket on arrival. You don't need to make any kind of reservations. But on the negative side, you will always have to first go to Mahon, and from Mahon you have to transfer onto another bus that will take you to your final destination. For this reason also, this is not for late arrivals, because if you have a late arrival, you might not have a connection anymore in Mahon. Also, do know that you may stop far from your hotel. In many of the resorts, there's only one or two bus stops, and it may be far away from your actual final destination and your hotel. And also do know that in July and August, the public bus transportation gets very busy in Menorca, and you might have to skip a bus to get onto the next bus if the bus is full before you get on. The prices for the public bus or public transportation is 3 euros to get you to Mahon. For any kind of destination like Salgar, Punta Prima, Binibeca, Escastei and Cala Emporter, it's about 4 euros. If you want to go a little bit further away to Sombu, Santo Tomas or Cala Galdana, it's about 6 euros. If you want to go all the way to the other side of the island, I would not advise this, because you will have to take 3 separate buses and it just will take a long time. I don't want to advise this, there's a much better way. If you want to go to Cittadella, however, I can advise you to take the public bus. You can get there for 8 euros, but also for here there is another way to other destinations more in the north like Fornells, Sonpark and Arnal de Castell. It's 7 euros. For most people traveling to Menorca, especially if you're traveling 1, 2 or 3 people, I would advise you to take the shuttle bus instead. The only drawback is that you have to book them before online. You cannot just get on at the Menorca airport, but it's quite easy to book them before online. They offer, in my opinion, the best value for money. Also, you get dropped off at your hotel reception, so not some random bus stop and you have to search from there. Something I would definitely not advise if you're flying late, especially not in the dark. It's not easy to find your hotel in a new destination. Also, there's no need to transfer first in Mahon, so not first have to go to Mahon and then take another bus to another destination. You just get on the bus at the airport and get dropped off at your hotel reception. Also, do know that there's a guaranteed connection if you arrive late in the evening, or if you're traveling in July and August when the bus system gets very busy, or if you have a delayed flight, they will always take care of you and you will always have a guaranteed connection. So how much does it cost? Well, for all the destinations on Menorca, the bus cost, the shuttle bus costs 11 euros. So I would not advise it for Mahon, Salgar, Punta Prima, Binibeca, Escanutels or Cala Emporter, unless you're arriving late in the evening or maybe in the weekend or July and August, then this might also be a good option. But I would definitely advise it for those people traveling to Cala Morei, Cala Blanes, Cala Sant'Andrea, Cala Blanca and Cala en Bosch, and maybe Cittadella if you want to take it a little bit more easy. For all the other destinations like Fornell, Sonpark, Arnal de Castell, Cala Galdana, Santo Tomas and Sombu, you have to see yourself. Do you think it's worth it to have a very easy and smooth experience if you pay 3 or 4 euros more than you normally would? This is something you have to decide yourself. In my opinion, I think it's also for those destinations a good thing to do if you don't mind paying a couple euros more. There are many different companies offering these kinds of services. The company I use when traveling and would advise, you can find on my website at checkedholidays.com/links. The fastest way to get from the Menorca airport to your hotel or destination is just to take a taxi. A taxi will get you there the fastest. There are prices announced at the airport taxi stops, but do know that these are not fixed prices. So if you get a delay or if there's a traffic jam along the way, these prices will go up. Also for the weekends and the night, the prices will go up. And do know that most of the taxis at the Menorca airport, for as far as I know, maximum take 4 people. So if you're traveling more than 4 people, you will need to take 2 taxis and you will be charged twice as well. Also, that most of the taxis don't have child safety seats or not always have child safety seats. So if you want child safety seats, I would always advise you to book before online. For many reasons, I would book before online to have a set price that doesn't go up, and also have a taxi waiting on arrival, and also have the child safety seats and have possibility to fit 5, 6 or 7 people in a taxi. For all these reasons, I would always advise you to book before online. Also for the taxis, I would advise you to use. You can find a link on my website to the company I use when traveling in Spain, and also the one I would advise to you at checkedholidays.com/links. So how much is it to take a taxi at the Menorca airport to Mahón? It's 14 euros. This doesn't include weekend or night rates or any delays or extra charges. This is just an estimate. Also 22 euros to Salgar, Punta Prima, Benibeca, Escanutels and Cala en Porter. 35 euros if you want to go to Son Bu or Santo Tomas. If you want to go to Cala Galdana, it's 45 euros. A little bit further to Cala en Bosch and all the other destinations like Cala Blanca, Cala Sant'Andrea, Cittadella and Cala en Blanes is 65 euros. And to Fornells and Son Park and Arnal den Castell is normally 73 euros.
If you're not 100% sure if this is the right holiday destination for you, feel free to have a look at any of these other videos. I have 250 more guides here on YouTube at the moment. And of course, you can also find many more on my website at checkedholidays.com.